Nigeria. I am your host, Oluwatobi Eneto. Welcome to another episode of What Next Education. Take a listen as my guest shares his thoughts on the challenges and way forward in basic education, putting the Federal Capital Territory, Abuja, in focus.
Generally, it has not been easy because managing basic education is not easy. That is the grassroots. Where others are not found, we are found there. So, and that tells you that we are spread all over the Federal Capital Territory, the nooks and crannies of the Federal Capital Territory. Our schools are found everywhere. The system is growing. Our schools are growing. Our schools are increasing in number. Our staff strength is supposed to equally be growing, to be increasing in number. Our needs are equally increasing. They are growing in number. So that is already a challenge. For you to make all these things grow at the same time, it is not easy. Now, bearing in mind the financial constraints that is prone to every organization, it is not easy to meet up with all these challenges. To make sure that we provide accessible, affordable, and qualitative basic education to every child resident in the Federal Capital Territory, it is not easy. It will require a lot of money. And requiring a lot of money at the time where the funds are not easily available, it is not easy. Now, for you to give quality education, you have to make sure that you have good teachers. For you to make schools affordable, you have to make sure that everything is provided for the children. For you to make sure that schools are accessible, you have to provide the schools so that the schools are actually accessible to children. Now, how do you make schools accessible to children? That means you have to establish schools in all the nooks and crannies so that students or pupils can easily get to these schools. Now, how do you make it affordable? You can only make schools affordable when you make sure that all the resources that are needed in those schools are provided. And that is when they can be affordable to the children. And then how do you make it qualitative? You make it qualitative when you now have quality teachers with qualitative instructional materials. That is it. So, and to get these things in place, it is not easy. All of them, they need money. For you to have all the number of teachers and the quality that you need, you have to make sure that you need money to employ good teachers and then to even train them. You need a lot of money to recruit new teachers and then train them. For you to make sure that you have instructional materials, they cost a lot of money, because it is not easy to provide all the instructional materials you need for all the classes at the same time. And then for you to make sure that you make a schools, in all the established schools in all the nooks and crannies, you have to make sure you need money so that you can go and build structures. You have to provide structures in these areas. It is not easy. All of them, they require a lot of money. And unfortunately, people who don't work in educational sectors, they don't understand what education needs. So many people are ignorant about what it takes to provide qualitative education that everybody will be proud of. People don't know what it costs to train a child in a year. People don't know what it means to take care of a teacher in a year. People don't know what it means to make a school child-friendly in a year. People don't know. So people don't know what it costs to manage educational institutions, especially at the basic level. People don't know. So many people are ignorant about this. And that is why when education managers begin to ask for money, because we don't generate revenue. We just provide, we are social service providers. We provide this social service to the children. So because we don't generate money, people look at it from that point of view. You These are people who only consume money, but they don't generate anything. So people get frustrated in trying to give us a fund. But we thank God that in the Federal Capital Territory, our minister understands that education sector does not generate money. All we need is we need to be given money so that we can manage and fund education properly. And the minister is doing a lot to make sure that our needs are adequately taken care of. There is no alternative. Education needs more. What is normally given to education is always not enough, and it will never be enough because we need a lot of things. Now that we are in a hurry to grow, to meet up with the developed countries, we are in a hurry to make sure that we jump from where we are to where developed countries are. And for us to do that, we need a lot of money to make sure that we provide all these infrastructures, instructional materials, the manpower that we require, which is always not adequate.
That was my guest, the executive director of the Universal Basic Education Board, who shared his thoughts on the challenges and way forward in basic education in the Federal Capital Territory. Until next time, I am Oluwatobi Enito.